Uh-oh. Is this gonna be bad or good? Hey! We welcome you all to the first ever episode of Monday Night Raw, live from the Carver Hawkeye Arena, and on the USA Network. I'm Jim Ross, alongside Jerry Lawler. I'm not really, I'm Dave Scott. What is going on, everybody? This is Dave Scott here, and right now I am back with another episode of Total Extreme Wrestling 2013 for you guys, and this is the first episode this time of WWE. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, you heard it 1 week from New Year's Revolution or Resolution or whatever the heck the pay-per-view is called. But I'm booking like crazy. I'm hyping like crazy. It's Raw time. So first off, we start off with a pre-show match in an extremely short match. Viscero defeated Shad in 5:21 by pinfall with a big splash. Any worker improvements? Shad is performing in performance skills. Shad has a negative crowd reaction, so we won't be using him that much. 40D, not a very good start. Then we move on to a 47. And about that, it's solid in reaction, but not much in the way heat. Kalito and Masters defeated Super Crazy and Eugene in 5:45, and Chris Masters defeated Super Crazy by submission with an Iron Cross. Tori Wilson did some good work at ringside, whoever she manages. Masters was off his game. Whoa, that's a lot of improvements. Kalito is improving in rumble skills, improving in technical skills, performing in performance skills. Eugene is performing in technical skills. And Chris Masters is performing in performance skills. Alright, so this mod likes to make people improve a lot. That's cool. We start off the night, ladies and gentlemen, with John Cena coming out to the ring, cutting a promo on Umaga. Umaga, rest in pieces, my friend. But, yeah, he is going to be talking about Umaga, saying how in recent weeks he has attacked Cena and hyped him and wanted a match. Well, he's going to get it at New Year's Resolution. And then, out of nowhere, Kane interrupts and says some stuff. Then Rated RKO comes out, and they go back and forth. And they eventually go to a match. John Cena was absolutely awful without a script. Kane didn't do well, nor did Edge, explaining the bad rating. But Randy was good, and that's good. He was the only one who wanted to go off script. But Randy's improving in acting. Randy has low morale because he didn't like that we gave him a fatherly approach to soft drugs. And, guys, I just realized my microphone isn't even down, so you probably couldn't hear me that well. Sorry about that, guys. It should be better now. Alright. So, the announcers put over the fact that we will be seeing Rated RKO versus Kane and John Cena in our main event tonight. ADB, cool. Very good. Alright. So, we start off the night in a match that's good action average heat. Degeneration X defeated Lance Cade and Trevor Murdoch. And 9:45 when Shawn Michaels defeated Lance Cade by pinfall with a flying elbow drop. Shawn Michaels looked good, and the performance of Triple H stood out as being good. Wow, this mod really does like to give a lot of improvements. That's awesome, I love that. Lance Cade is improving in rumble, technical, and performing in performance skills. Trevor Murdoch performing in performance skills, as is Triple H. Cool. Good, 74 B-, good start. And then we have D-Generation X cutting a promo, hyping their upcoming match at New Year's Resolution with Rated RKO. I'll go ahead and book that in. New Year's Revolution, it is. I don't know. What are you talking? Don't yell at me. Alright, Cena versus, who's only 29, versus Umaga. Auto name. And we're going to book 2v2. Rated RKO versus DX. Cool. For the tag team titles of the world. 72B minus Shelton Benjamin attacking Ric Flair backstage, leaving him down and out. Shelton wants to make his name. Storyline was added because 2 hours is a long time to book with a brand split. And plus, New Year's Revolution only has like a few matches on the cards, and I'm expected to book 3 hours of that? Alright, sure. 72B minus, and then about that, it saw it in reaction, not much on the way. Heat Shelton Benjamin defeated Val Venus in 10:30 by pinfall. Shelton Benjamin improving in performance skills. I mean, Oh, I said that I broke the streak. He's performing in performance skills. Another 59. Val Venus is in the ring giving an interview when Shelton Benjamin attacks him post-match. But then, woo! Ric Flair comes out and cleans house, making the save. Shelton Benjamin improving acting. Cool. That's nice. And then he cuts a promo on Rick after. So they're going to get booked in at New Year's Revolution as well. Here we go. It is Ric Flair, who doesn't have good momentum, versus Shelton Benjamin, who has excellent momentum. Cool. Alright, then we go on to a 47 and extremely short match. Umaga defeated JTG in 4:33 by pinfall with a wild Samoan drop. Then we have Umaga performing in performance skills and JTG performing in performance skills. Fades due to manager. I'm not sure what that means. Then Armado Estrada had an interview hyping the upcoming singles match between his client Umaga and John Cena. Mickey James and Victoria are backstage. An argument breaks out and they start brawling with each other. A whole host of road agents and staff have to pull them apart. Then we go on to a number one contenders match for the women's title. Victoria defeats Candice Michelle in an awful match. And they had great chemistry, too. That's the sad thing. And it's that bad. But nonetheless, Victoria is number one contender. And if I could, I would get Miss April and Brittany Knight on the card. But they're not in the database. I might actually just have to cheat and bring them in. If you guys would allow it. Alright, so Victoria and Mickey for the women's title at New Year's Revolution. Then, Vince McMahon appears on the Titantron. He is backstage saying that a new authority figure will be revealed this coming Monday on Raw. Mainly because I didn't have time to sign him before this Raw. So the new general manager of Raw is going to be revealed next week. So yeah, Vince McMahon was struggling when going off script. And then we have, in a match that's a good action average heat, John Morrison defeated Jeff Hardy in 11:40 by pinfall with a standing shooting star press after Melina interfered. So, Jeff performing in performance skills, John improving in rumble skills, and technical skills, and flying skills. Alright, 74B minus, that's good. Okay. So, Morrison has beat the number one, has beat the Intercontinental Champion, albeit due to tainted stuffs, but Jeff challenges John, and I thought that'd be a little better. He says he's gonna put his title on the line to get revenge on Hennigan. So there's our next match. I know I'm booking like crazy, but guys, you would too if it is, you only had 1 week. And the bad thing is, this is a brand pay-per-view, so I can't hype anything for it on SmackDown, because SmackDown's a whole different brand, so, whatever. John Cena is walking back down a backstage hallway on the way to the ring. 77B, being short, alright. Then in our main event, we have a 87B+, that's nice. That's nice. About to feature great action and a good crowd. Kane. Oh, sorry. My recording software went weird there. Started flashing and made me nervous. Alright, anyways, about to feature great action and a good crowd. Kane and John Cena defeated Rated RKO in 1552 when John Cena defeated Edge by pinfall at a spin out powerbomb. 87B+, I didn't think it'd do that well. It's awesome. Kane performing in performance skills, John Cena improving in rumble and flying skills, and performing in performance skills, Randy Orton performing in performance skills as well. That's good, that was a really good main event, I'm happy with that. That closes the show. Oh, nope, John Cena's celebrating his victory in the ring, Umaga runs and attacks, beating Cena down to the mat. So that show got an 87B+, that is nice. I think I'm gonna turn on just letters for that, I think that would make it easier. But show increased their popularity in 24 regions. That is really, 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 really nice. And I'm not sure how long. Yeah, this mod is not gonna take long at all to load, which is awesome. But still, it's gonna take a little while. So guys, I will see you all with the main title screen. Okay, guys, I promise you this. I kid you not. Not 10 seconds after I paused the recording, the thing was here. That's awesome. So, Raw has been getting fantastic reviews. That's awesome to see. Ted DiBiase Jr. is on the rise. I think I have, think I'm, I might hire him, I might not. Nobody we really want here. Yeah, so. ROH fired some people. Alright, so let's take a look at our emails. Oh, okay. So apparently some people are trying to get Heyman. We got him. Alright, so, ratings warnings. USA does not like it. We do at 8.23. What are you talking about? Well, if we lose USA, that's gonna be tough for us. Incident involving Sean Morley, who has been Val Venus, steroid user, disciplinary log. Fatherly approach. Suspension now. All right. Yeah, we're trying to sign a crap load of people. But anyways, guys, yeah, we are getting Big Show extending his contract, getting in Brock Lesnar, 'cause 88 popularity overall is awesome. Trying to re-sign the Basham brothers, getting Rey Mysterio Jr. 'cause for some reason he wasn't signed to me in this mod. Bryan Danielson for development, Austin Aries for development, Alberto Del Rio for development, R-Truth for no, for the main roster. He's PBA with TNA, so I figured that I might bring him back. Ted DiBiase Jr. for development, Claudio Castagnoli for development, Chris Hero for development, Brody Lee for development, Jon Moxley for development, Tyler Black for development, Matt Sydal for development, Paul Heyman for Brock Lesnar, and the Raw General Manager. Yeah. So that's cool. Now, the thing is, I think that each episode I'm going to be doing, since it's a competitive brand split, I'm going to be doing the Raw and SmackDown in one episode, because as you see, this is only 11 minutes long. I like to have my episodes go, at least 20 minutes, so I'm gonna do that. And so there we go. New Year's Revolution. I don't really know. I'm gonna have to make those matches really long. I don't know if there's anything else I can do. Thank God I added Flair and Benjamin, because it's gonna be hard doing a brand split and all that. But yeah. So take a look at storylines right here. All right. So 58 for there. 47, 87, 54, 77. Could be better. So yeah, we might want to add one more for there. We have, do we have, did we ever find anybody for Benoit? I think we did. Yeah, Kennedy and Benoit. Yeah. Okay. So what's our main event on SmackDown we haven't used? I probably did this last episode and didn't even do anything with it. All right. Really nobody that much. Only buddy is King Booker. So we can have like a random feud with him. Upper mid card faces on SmackDown. Matt Hardy and King Booker. It's going in a feud. Book it. All right. So King Booker versus Matt Hardy. All right. So there we go. That is that. Now, guys, I will see you all when we are at SmackDown.
Breaking ground, back your dance. Now it's gone, but today,
everyone, to WWE SmackDown, the first ever episode in this WWE 2007 series. I hope you all enjoyed the video. If you are, be sure to smack that like button, comment down below, and subscribe. And we are on the first episode of SmackDown, guys, and I forgot to do one thing. I will be right back. Alright, we're back, and welcome again to WWE SmackDown. So guys, we're going to start off with a few pre-show matches, then we'll get right into this show. And about that, I saw it in reaction, but I mentioned the way Heat Finley defeated Scotty 2-Hotty at 557 by pinfall with the Tombstone Piledriver, while Scotty 2-Hotty is improving it. I did that twice this episode! Performing and performance skills, and, neither can go all out. 46D, that's alright. Then we move on to, in a match that's a good action average heat, Batista defeated Jamie Noble in 539 by pinfall with a sit-out facebuster. So, Jamie Noble performing and performance skills, as is Batista, 66 rating, pretty good. And then Batista attacks Jamie Noble. This is for the sole purpose of this. Yeah, that's alright. At least it wasn't a complete failure or whatever. Alright. So we move on to the main show. Wow, 98, that's awesome. Batista comes out of the ring, takes the microphone, starts talking to the crowd, eventually interrupted by gong, 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 The Undertaker in the big war of words, but no brawl, because that's not what the Undertaker ain't about that life. 98, right. That's awesome. Then we move on to Matt Hardy cutting a, well, it's supposed to be in-ring promo, and then he goes on to defeat William Regal in a match that's some good action and average heat. With the flying light drop, Matt Hardy performing and performing skills, as is William Regal. Pretty good, 64. And then a 79, pretty good. Matt Hardy's in the ring giving an interview. King Booker comes out and enters the ring after some back and forth insults. He attacks, laying Matt Hardy out, but then gong. The second appearance of the night for The Undertaker, saving Matt Hardy from King Booker, as that sets up our main event for tonight. Apparently, wife and husband don't work well together. So I guess I'll take them off. Chris Benoit is backstage. Man. Chris Benoit is backstage arguing with Mr. Kennedy. It gets heated and the shouting catches the attention of Teddy Long. The general manager who's passing by walks in and books them in a singles match for the United States title later on tonight. Chris Benoit was absolutely awful. Teddy Long was pretty good though. That explains the poor rating. And then we have, and about that I saw it in reaction, but not much in the way of heat, the Boogeyman defeated Chavo Guerrero in 6:53 by pinfall. It's a 7-minute match, Boogeyman. Are you kidding me? Wow. Boogeyman performing in performance skills and then a terrible rating. The Boogeyman is celebrating his victory in the ring, the Hurricane runs in and attacks him. Man, these aren't doing well. 57, about that saw it in reaction, but not much in the way heat. London and Kendrick defeated The Miz and Montel Vontavious Porter in 8:19 when Paul London defeated The Miz by pinfall with Get Well Soon. Tag champs get a win. MVP's performing in performance skills. Cool. Jesus, why is this doing terrible? The Miz comes up to Tori Wilson and asks her on a date, but she rejects it. This is just like a throwaway segment. I don't know. Benoit has an interview on how much he hates Mr. Kennedy. Their match did pretty awful, actually. Match that's a good action average heat. Chris Benoit defeated Mr. Kennedy in 12:35 by pinfall with the Dragon Suplex. Chris Benoit makes defense number one of his WWE United States title. This main event better come through. 78, okay, alright. They don't actually form an alliance here, people. Don't read the text. It's all that Matt Hardy just goes up to The Undertaker thanking him for his, you know, his help earlier tonight. Undertaker really doesn't respond. Alright, then we go to The Undertaker makes an elaborate entrance. Please do well. Alright. It's not too bad, to be honest, but I mean, it could be better. I wish it was better. And about the feature, great action, a good crowd, The Undertaker defeated King Booker in 16:13 by pinfall with a choke slam. Undertaker performing in performance skills. Yeah, alright, I'll take it. 95, there we go. Undertaker cuts a post-match promo on Batista to close out SmackDown. So Raw wins the ratings war this week, but SmackDown is not far behind, so if it can just get 3 points over, it would have secured the victory. But guys, for the second time this episode, I will see you all at the main title screen.
All right, everybody, we are back here with some decisions. Oh my god! 2 days into the game and Robert Fuller dies. Aw, that's sad. Aw. Okay, so Brian Kendrick was injured. Damaged kneecap. How long is he out for? Ah, he's working through it. Just be quiet. Alright, TNA Impact. Let's see how they did. 75, good for them. Jordan Angle defeated Scott Steiner and Christian Daniels and Killings. Wow, alright. Pretty good. Good for them. It's cool to see how TNA is doing like at this early of a stage. They're bringing in new faces. Cool for them. Alright, so. HW, are you really trying to take my talent? Okay. Try all you want, guys. It's not going to happen. It's not going to happen. Yeah. Yeah, no. Alright, so. Kendrick was injured, but he's working through it, so. Let's see here. Alright, Alberto Del Rio has signed for development as a heel. Alright, Dos Caras Juniors and Matt Sydal. Alright. Cool, just one of them many. Ah, Batista, what's... Oh, yeah, botched turn. I'm sorry, buddy. That was my fault. That's my bad. Alright. So, New Year's Revolution is in a few days. Even though that turn just absolutely didn't go well, Batista is number one on the hot list. Are you kidding me? Mind blown. Alright, then. So, New Year's Revolution, guys, has five matches on the card. I wouldn't buy it. I wouldn't expect you guys to either. It's first pay-per-view, you know. Rumble is, you know, it's what's going to be important. I'm not going to be really going in any direction with SmackDown until, you know, after New Year's Revolution, which is in the next show. So, after New Year's Revolution, I'm going to be hyping the Rumble on both Raw and SmackDown, doing some qualifying matches. I don't even really know who I want to win yet. I guess I'm going to have to think that out over time. But, guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope you all enjoyed. If you did, be sure to smack that like button and comment down below if you want to see more... Wait, what? Comment down below and subscribe if you're new and want to see more content like this. Welcome to the channel. Thank you all for 250 subscribers. And with that being said, keep subscribing up there and comment down below. And I will see you next time, guys.